In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which Spotfire bar charts may be used to visualize data, including the traditional bar chart configuration, where you can compare sums or averages, or the configuration of histograms, where you can examine data distribution. Let's take a look at how to interpret these two types of bar chart visualizations. Most commonly, bar charts are configured to represent aggregate measures of a group of values, such as a sum, average, or median. This type of bar chart would be useful for making comparisons or examining patterns or trends. For example, which department displays the highest total amount of purchases? The furniture department. Alternatively, bar charts may be configured like a histogram in order to examine data distribution by displaying bar height as a count of values. In this circumstance, the continuous measure is placed along the category axis and is often binned in an effort to gather data into groups based upon data ranges. For example, here our customers' ages have been grouped or binned into 12 ranges, and the count of customers in each age range is reflected in the height of each bar. So, where is our peak demographic age range? We have the largest number of customers in the 25 to 28-year-old age bin. Let's take a look at some bar charts which have already been configured within a TIBCO Spotfire analysis document. Use Open File in order to navigate to the configured Spotfire analysis document with Interpreting Bar Charts in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The data table which supports this analysis contains purchase data for customers shopping at a Megamart chain of department stores. On this page, two simple bar charts have been configured. The bar chart on the left compares the total electronics purchase amounts made by men versus women, while the bar chart on the right displays the average electronics purchase amount made by men versus women at each store setting. And even though both bar charts have gender applied as the color by variable, it is important to note that the gender in this bar chart actually defines a grouping of values which is distinct and separate from the variable applied to the category axis, thus resulting in side-by-side bars and allowing for an easy comparison of gender-based electronics purchases in each store setting. Also, note that the value axis references the same column of data in each visualization, but the aggregation of values from that column is different in each chart, a sum in one and an average in the other. And because the sum of electronics purchases for each gender results in rather large values, the format applied to the numbers displayed in this bar chart substitute a letter K for the three trailing zeros, which would make this bar height read $36,000. The numbers in this bar chart are not large enough to be suitable for that type of short number format, indicating that numbers may be formatted differently in different visualizations. On the next page, both bar charts have been configured to display horizontal bars. This bar chart compares average purchase amounts across four different departments in each store location. Each department is represented by a separate column of data in the underlying data table. Therefore, each of those four columns has been assigned to the value axis, and the color by variable has been set to group data into bars of different colors based upon each column name. You will also notice that a reference line has been drawn at a fixed position of 150 in order to aid in the comparison across all locations. This bar chart has been configured with multiple columns assigned to the category axis. Consequently, the bars are split first by major store location, then split again by the store setting, thus creating a hierarchy. The final level of the hierarchical split is defined by the color by variable, which groups the data into separate bars for each gender. You may have noticed that there are two scales displayed on this bar chart, one colored pink, the other blue. This is because the values from each gender have been set to define their range based upon separate scales, where the upper range limit is defined by the longest bar for that gender. Therefore, relative comparisons of maximum purchase amounts made by men versus women are readily available in each category. But a comparison of absolute values is extremely cumbersome in a bar chart configured in this manner. While these bar charts use color to define side-by-side bars, the bar charts on this page use color to define stacked bar segments. This bar chart displays absolute total electronics purchase amounts made at each major store location as the overall bar height, and you can see that this label indicates the value for the complete bar. Each bar is also subdivided by the store setting where the purchase was made, and labels showing the amount represented by each of those bar segments has been displayed. The bar chart on the right shows exactly the same data. However, the overall bars have been normalized to a height of 100%. Again, while absolute comparisons are no longer possible, relative comparisons of the percent contribution of stores from each setting toward that location's total are now made available for comparison. On the next page, the bar chart visualization has been configured in an entirely different fashion. Here, the amount each customer has spent on shoes has been selected as the category axis variable. You can see that 20 bins have been derived from these values. This means that the shoe purchase amounts have been grouped into 20 bins, or purchase amount ranges, in order to form 20 bars in this bar chart. And the value axis has been configured to count customers in each of those bins. Therefore, we can see how many customers made lower shoe purchase totals and how many customers made higher shoe purchase totals. Hopefully, it is immediately clear that this histogram represents two distinct populations of shoe purchasers, and it just so happens that each population is aligned with a gender, indicated by color. If you would prefer to change the number of bars or groupings of customers in an attempt to achieve a better resolution of these distribution patterns, you can slide this bin slider to the right. As we do, it becomes clear that while the distribution is bimodal, the two populations are not completely separated, and outlying customers of each gender occupy an overlapping region of shoe purchase amounts in the center of the overall range. On the final page of this configured analysis, a traditional bar chart has been created, which shows the total electronics purchase amounts made at each store, resulting in 84 bars. In order to make this chart easier to interpret, those 84 bars have been sorted from tallest to shortest, going from left to right. In addition, a zoom slider has been added, which allows us to zoom in on the taller bars, such that we can read the individual store number values. In addition, we could grab in the middle of the resized slider's gray region and drag in the direction of the shorter bars in order to examine adjacent store number values along the way. This bar chart has been configured as a histogram, and the count of customers is reflected in the height of each bar. Currently, all customers from the underlying data table are contributing to the height of each bar. However, if we use the filters panel to remove Los Angeles customers from the bar chart, you can see that the visualization has been configured to show a shadow, indicating the bar height prior to the application of filtering. So, while subsequent filtering to remove all suburban customers from the visualization will further decrease the height of the orange bars, the height of the shadows will continue to display the age distribution pattern of the unfiltered customers from the underlying data table.